In this video, we are going to be discussing about screen sizes and how to make your game fit the screen sizes of different devices. So I have made a new empty project in GDevelop, and in my game settings, go to property, I have changed this resolution. I have put the width to 1080 and height to 1920. And these are my options: change width to fit the screen or window size, and update resolution. So let's see how to make our game properly fit different devices. Here I have a list of devices and their resolutions. So you can see there are so many of them, right? And I'm looking at phones right now. You can look at tablets and you will get the resolution for tablets. So there are plenty of resolutions, plenty of devices with different resolutions. So it's not possible to adjust your game according to every device. So what should we do in this case? Well, GDevelop handles it on its own, as we saw in the game settings. In the properties, it will simply change width to fit the screen size, but that may not work sometimes. So let us test out something and see how to solve this problem. I will add a background to my scene. This is totally empty. I don't have any events or anything. Let's add a background. I will call it background, add animation, and you can say default. Or should I add a tiled sprite? I will add a tiled sprite because I will want to change its width and height, I mean spread it across the area. So I will call it background. I will select an image. I have this bg.png background and it has a resolution of 1080 x 1920. I will choose this, and there it is. In the width I will type 1080, and in the height I will type 1920. So that is good. Click on apply. I will drag this background my scene. I will try to adjust it. You can adjust it from here. You can put x as 0 and y as 0. It will be centered, right? So let's run our game and see how it looks like. So with the default settings, our game looks like this. So our width has been increased to fit this size. If I change the size of my window, if I change the size of my window, you can see that it will change its width. Width is being changed. I can change the width, and it will simply be there. Right, if I change the height, you can see that my width is being changed, right, automatically like this. So this is not very good because it's not the ideal thing. There will be black bars here if you do it this way. If your mobile phone has an aspect ratio of 16:9, then it will look properly. But if it has something else, suppose the aspect ratio is something different, then it will be different, right? As you keep on increasing the height, it will keep on increasing the width. As you can see, I decrease the height, it will decrease the width. So if your phone has an aspect ratio of 4:3, then you will have black bars here, right? That's not good. So how do we deal with that? Let me stretch my background and see what happens. It's a tiled background, so it will stretch properly. Oh well, it's not a tileable, tileable sprite which I chose from the internet. So that might be the problem. This line in the middle, but that's not a very big problem. We can solve it very easily. So let me see if I can stretch it like this. It will get stretched all the way. It is okay. I simply want to test something. So if my background is covering more area than the screen, let's see what happens then. You can see that it is displaying the background to me all over, but this may not be looking very good to you. So I will do one thing. I will add a sprite simply and call it background dark, and I will choose the background, apply, and bring it here. And I will simply take it and stretch it, but I will not stretch it like this. You can. I will do that. It will change its aspect ratio, but we are just testing something. So I have my background way overflowing the actual area. So now you can get a better representation of what's happening. That's what's happening. If I change the width, it will stay like this. But if I change the height, it will decrease the width. Right, which is not very good. Because if I put some object inside this, let me put some object here. I will make a sprite and call it object. You can call it test object. Add an animation, say default, and you can edit with pixel. So I have this object, right? I will bring some more of them, right? So yeah, let's see now what we see in the scene. So you can see that our objects are this way. And our scene ends here, but we can see the whole background. If you decrease the width, it will simply do this. If I decrease the height, it will decrease the size of the objects, right? As you can see. So that's what this setting does. This setting of change width to fit the screen or window size, right? So let me now do no changes to the game size. Let's see what happens then. So you can see that I have black bars here and here. There is no change to the window size, but I have black bars. It is not good, doesn't look good. I should have had the background here, but it's not there. If I decrease the size, if I change the aspect ratio, the aspect ratio of the game stays the same, right? I mean, it's we are not distorting the game, which is good, but we have black bars. So that's one thing. I mean, this setting will also let your game run on different screen sizes without distorting the aspect ratio of the game itself, but it will not look good because we have black bars here and here. So if you are playing on a tablets are like this, you will have big black bars. You know, tablets look like this almost, right? And you will have black bars here and here. That doesn't look very good, right? So let's explore some other setting and see if that works. Go to properties and I will select change width to fit the screen. Oh no, change height to fit the screen or window size. Let's see what happens now. and run the game. Okay, this is kind of weird. I am not even able to see my whole game. If I change the aspect ratio, kind of it's messy. It's not showing me the whole game, so that option is very bad. Let's close this. And now we can do one more thing. I will go back to change width to fit the screen or window size. And you can see that this option was checked the whole time. I will now uncheck it and check and see what happens to the game. Okay, and now you can see that I have this. It's again, there are black bars. I don't have the background here and here, which I should have had. And if I change the aspect ratio, suppose, then it stays there, it stays the same. My game is not getting distorted, but again I have black bars. So again, let's do this, change the height. Let's see what happens. And if I run, you can see I have my game, but I still have the black bars. If I change the aspect ratio, it's working well. It's working the same way as the width one was working, because I have switched off this one, right? So basically, you can see that nothing is working very well. You still have black background, black bars, and how to deal with that? Let's see if there is a way in which we can deal with the black bars, because black bars is one way for the system to keep the aspect ratio of the game intact. Otherwise it will change the aspect ratio and that will not look good. So, and I will assume that if you want to do the adjustment of aspect ratio and screen sizes, you are doing it at the very end of the development of your game. So I will assume that you cannot move around your object like this, right? And try to adjust to different screen sizes. So I will assume that. So we need a solution which is quick and easy. Let me see on the GDevelop forums if I can do something like change the black bars to some color or some background. GDevelop black bars to color, and there are a couple of forum questions. Let's have a look at them. I do not have anything related to that here, and so doesn't look like And this guy says that with the second option, the black border color is determined with the scene background color. So I have to modify the camera render zone. Let me see if I can do it in GDevelop. So I may have one camera, but wait. I can't see it. Okay, anyway, let me do it from the events. So I'm in the event. I will add a new event, maybe at the beginning of the scene. Okay, add action, and I will type camera. I can see a couple of actions. I mean, yeah, zoom, show a layer, effect parameters, change camera angle, enable layer effect. What are these effect? Let me see if there are any effects here. I don't find anything. So let me see if I can have some layer effects. I don't know what this guy is trying to say. Okay, they say that render zone is only available on native only, which means that, you know, your render zone setting will only work on desktop, right? So that's not very ideal. So I guess one way is to simply let the black bars be there. I mean, if you are using a tablet, you will have this kind of black bars, right? And that may look bad. So that's what we are trying. We were trying to eliminate, but it's kind of difficult to do in GDevelop, I guess. I guess that's a solution. Your game will not lose its aspect ratio, but you will have black bars here and here. And I don't seem to find any other solution to that, right? So let me see if I have any action for render. The scene, change background color. Now this can be kind of Interesting. Let's see what will happen. I will choose a color of blue, and I will see if it does anything. I don't think it will do anything, but let's see. No, it's still not doing anything really. So, yeah. That's what we can do. This is bad. I mean, okay, if your tablet is this way, you can have the background here. You will not have black bars, right? But okay, I think you can do one thing, which is this, I guess, but let's see if it works. So what is the center point of our screen? It is you know, half of 1080 and half of 1920, right? But let's not do it this way. Let us put the, you know, event. Let us put some action, add action, and I will type camera. Change the exposition of the center of the specified camera. Yeah, that's what I want to do. Is equal to value. Value should be scene width of the scene window, and divided by 2, I guess, and yeah, that's the X position, right? And base layer camera number default, which is 0 for on. Yeah, okay. And do the same for the Y position of the camera. Camera center Y position is equal to scene height of the scene window. Then simply say upon 2. And base layer and 0 camera. Click on OK. And so we have centered the camera on our game. And let's see if that does anything different for us. That doesn't do anything. But oh well. It should have. You know what, I will do one more thing. I will take an object, I will add a new object, I will call it center. I will add an animation, I will call it default. And simply draw something, maybe a black square or something. Fill it with white color and save it and apply and bring it here. And put its position as, okay, wait, x as 540 and y as 960. So this object is at the center now, right? That's pretty good. And now I will do something. I will delete these two events as they are not doing anything right now for us. And I will change this, center the camera on an object. Object is center. Anticipate the movement of the object, yeah, I guess. And camera number is 0. Click on OK. Let's see if this does anything for us at all. Yeah, it worked, I guess. If I change this, it will simply change the it will. Okay, it's kind of weird. I guess I will have to check it in my phone different phones, that is. If I'm changing the aspect ratio, then which people will not be able to do in phones, right? You can't just change the aspect ratio of your phone yourself. So let's test this out on a phone. I mean, so my settings are this. Wait, this resolution, change width to fit the screen or window size, and update resolution during the game. And I have added one event at the beginning of the scene. But if I add it in, you know, every frame, then something may happen. Let's see. So you can see, if I do it like this, it is always. I can see the nice background. I don't have black bars, and I have the game. I mean, the camera center to the game. Let me change the aspect ratio. You can see that when I'm changing the aspect ratio. So this is the aspect ratio of a monitor. My game is being resized. It's not losing its aspect ratio. So if I do it like a tablet, so tablets look like this, almost. So this is a tablet now, and you can see that iPads are like this. So you can see that my game is looking very beautiful. I have no black bars and a nice background. So I guess this is going to work very well. But I will test it out on my phone. So I guess this is the correct way to do it without having to change everything. First thing which you should do is go to your properties and do this game resolution width to 1080 and height to 1920, and this one to change width to fit the screen or window size, and check this option, update resolution during the game to fit the screen or window size. Click on apply and add this simple event, add a new event, and every frame we could simply do this center camera on center. What is center? Center is an object which we made, and this object is placed by us at the center of the game, at the center of our scene, right? And we are centering the camera on this object every frame. So now it's looking very good. We don't have black bars, and we have our game in the proper aspect ratio. So I guess this will work. So yeah, that is one way you can do it. It is working. Now I will kind of put it in my phone. But I have only one phone right now. I will see if I can find some emulator to emulate this game. I have Android Studio, and it has many devices. So I will pause the recording and wait for the uploader. I mean, wait for the build to happen. So I have installed the game in my phone, and as you can see that it's running pretty well in my phone. But the thing is that my phone has the aspect ratio of 16:9 itself. So that may not be a very good test of whether it's running properly or not. So the thing is that it's working pretty well, but that's a way in which you can do what we are trying to do. And let's make it a little bit better. You will have to add this event, this action on all your scenes, but you will also have to add this object and center it, and that is a lot of work, right? So let's make it a global object. That is a global object, and this is now a global object, right? So we can simply create the object at the beginning of the scene. So at the beginning of the scene, add action objects, create an object from its name, and object is center right. Oh, well, create and just choose create an object. Exposition is, I guess it was 540. Y position was 960, I believe. And layer is base layer, and click on OK. And yeah, so 540, 960. Yeah. What these two actions will do is that this will create the object at the position this center object, which is a global object, and then this action will center the camera on the center object. So these two pieces of code will do that, do this thing for you automatically. So I can simply delete this from the scene, right? And then test the game out. Yeah. So let's test it. So yeah, this is also working, but I cannot see the object, but it's working, and that's good. And you are putting it in base layer, and that's the first thing that is being put on the stage, and I think the background is being put after it. So the center object goes below the background, so it is not visible. But anyway, we don't want it to be visible, so add another action, visibility hide the specified object, center object. So just hide it, and let's see if it works or not. It's working so far. So if I do this, it works. Yeah, if your screen is small, too small, then it will get cut. If your screen is like this, then yeah, I mean, look at this. It's so, it cuts the scene, right? Look at this. And that can be a problem sometimes. If your mobile phone is smaller than the width of your scene, then it will be cut if you choose the width option. So that is something which you may also have to figure out. We can figure that out by changing the aspect ratio of our game again. So I have seen that the most common aspect ratio for phones, it's 16:9, so we are in luck. But there can be others also. I think there is a, so you can leave it at 16:9 or 9:16, right? There is 18:9 and 19:9. Should you care? Of course you should. There is 18:5:9. The width is decreasing, so that means the phone is getting thinner. In this case the width has increased, so the phone has gotten thicker, right? And wait, it has increased. Yeah, phone has gotten thicker. But if you go for 19:5, again the width has increased and the height has also decreased. So the phone has gotten thicker, but that's okay. So 16:9 is the most common aspect ratio, it seems, and you can simply go for it. If you want to make it even thinner, then you can make it thinner by decreasing your width. You can decrease your width and keep your height the same, and it will go thin. But that will not be a standard aspect ratio. Make sure that it's standard. Right, and so that should work for your game. If it doesn't work, you can simply change this to anything you want. I guess to you want to decrease the width, you can go for 720 and keep it this way only and see what happens. So your game has become so thin, but it will still work. Let me show you. It's at, still at the center, and you can have an overflowing background and you don't have black bars. It will work in very thin fonts also. No phone will be so thin, right? But that's just for example. So I will simply change it back to 1080, and yeah, so that's how you can simply choose the smallest width with these options. With this option, change width to fit the screen size. You can simply choose the smallest width which you can choose, and that width will be able to work on all the devices in this way, by using all these events, this global object and this option. If you do all this, then you can change the width and it will work. Make it smaller and it will work on all devices almost, and your game will not lose the aspect ratio, and it will be centered, the camera will be centered at your game. And so that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope it helped you.